Upload file. The Upload File option relies on the user creating a text file that conforms to the specification established in the Electronic Emissions Inventory File Specifications document posted on the EAS webpage at www.tceq.texas.gov/air-quality/point-source-ei/psei.html. Other documents and reference material for use in creating the Electronic Emissions Inventory text file are also located on this page. Once a text file is created, the user logs into STEERS, navigates to the Air Emissions Inventory Detail page, and clicks the Upload File button, located near the top of the page. This opens the Upload Air Emissions Inventory File page. Depending on the browser, the user will see a button labeled Choose File or Browse. Clicking this button will open a window that allows the user to navigate on their computer to the location of the text file. The file must be less than 13 megabytes in size and named using the site's RN, followed by _upload.txt. Only text files with the file extension of .txt will be accepted. No other file types can be imported through this window. After selecting the file and clicking Open, the user is returned to the Upload Air Emissions Inventory File page. From here, the user clicks the Upload File button located below the Choose/Browse option. This begins the process of loading the file into the AEIR work area and initiates the data check routines. Once this process is complete, the user will be notified by email of the results. The emissions inventory status will also update to either imported or import error. Any errors will be detailed in a log attached to the notification email and can be viewed through the error log in STEERS AEIR. The errors must be addressed and an updated file loaded into AEIR. Data loaded into the work area in this manner cannot be edited directly. Any changes to the data must be made offline and an updated text file imported in its entirety. Partial file uploads are not allowed. Once a complete and error-free file is successfully imported into STEERS AEIR, the user with submit authority can submit the data to the TCEQ. The process for submitting the AEIR data is detailed in Video 8.